Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about Karl Fischer titration or Karl Fischer echometry. So as its name suggests, echometry means to determine the water content. So Karl Fischer echometry or Karl Fischer titration is used to determine the water content or moisture content present in any drug or any other sample. So so first I am going to discuss about the Karl Fischer reagent, that is KFR. Composition of KFR is, it contains iodine plus it contains SO2 plus it contains C5H5N, that is pyridine, plus it contains methanol. Quantity of iodine is 45 gram, SO2 20 gram, pyridine 80 mg and methanol 400 ml. So this is the composition of Karl Fischer reagent. Nowadays in the place of pyridine, nowadays imidazole is used because pyridine is carcinogenic in nature. Nowadays imidazole is used in the place of pyridine because pyridine is carcinogenic in nature, so imidazole can be used in the place of pyridine. Formula for imidazole is C3H4N2. Okay, now next step is preparation of Karl Fischer reagent, preparation of KFR. So for preparation of KFR, first we have to take the 400 ml methanol in a stoppered conical flask. So first we have to take 400 ml methanol in a stoppered conical flask, then add 80 mg pyridine and dissolve this pyridine in the methanol. Then in second step, keep this conical conical containing the solution in a freezing bath. And supply SO2 in the cold solution. After that, in this solution we have to add 45 gram of iodine and dissolve properly and kept for 24 hours. Okay, after then add 45 gram of iodine and dissolve properly by shaking, then keep this solution for 24 hours, then our KFR reagent is ready. KFR is ready for use. And 1 ml of KFR is equivalent to 3.5 mg water. So this is the basic steps involved in preparation of KFR. First, we have to take the 400 ml methanol in a stoppered flask, stoppered conical flask. Then we will add 80 mg pyridine. We will dissolve properly. After that, we have to keep this solution in a freezing bath. In freezing bath, our solution will cool down. In the cold solution, we have to pass the SO2 gas till the total weight of the conical will be increased by 20 gram. So total weight of SO2 which is dissolved in our solution or mixed in our solution is 20 gram. Then we have to add 45 gram of iodine, and we will dissolve this iodine by shaking. After after properly shaking, our KFR, that is Karl Fischer reagent, is ready. We have to keep this Karl Fischer reagent for 24 hours, and this is ready for use. Our KFR is ready for use. Then 1 ml of KFR is equivalent to 3.5 mg of water. Now come to the instrumentation part. In instrumentation part, there are different parts present in the Karl Fischer instrument. First one is vessel. In the vessel, there will be one anode and one cathode. There will be one inner burette. In inner burette, lower part membrane will be there, so liquid can go through. Then in the inner vessel, we have to put our sample. From here here is the sample inlet. From here we can keep our sample in the vessel. Here it is piston burette. Here piston is present. By using piston, we can push the KFR. Here is KFR, that is Karl Fischer reagent. By using the piston, we can push the Karl Fischer reagent for titration slowly. So here our sample will be present. In which we have to determine the amount of water or amount of moisture present. So we have to keep our sample here. Then we have to add the KFR, that is Karl Fischer reagent. In titration, certain changes will occur. For example, what changes occur and how we can determine the end point. In this Karl Fischer titration, end point determination is done by colorimetry. Means here anode and cathode is there, so current flow will be there, and that will be measured. Current flow will be measured or monitored. So let's see the equations. What happens in step 1? Water molecule will be there, plus SO2 plus I2. So here it will be SO3 plus HI. Here HI is there. HI means H plus and I minus. Okay, so here sample is present. In our sample, water is present. Okay, we are titrating our sample with Karl Fischer reagent. In Karl Fischer reagent, iodine is there and SO2 is there. Due to presence of iodine, iodine will convert into HI and SO2 will convert into SO3. So iodine will convert into HI, means that will be from I2 to, it is directly convert to I minus, means iodine is ionized. So due to presence of I minus ion, current flow will start. Water content is more, current flow will be more. At the end point, water content will be finished. So by adding the KFR reagent, there will be no increment in the current flow. That will be the end point. So basically, amount of water is directly, means our moles of the water is directly proportional to the moles of the iodine present in the Karl Fischer titration. In next step, what will happen? This SO3 will react with pyridine and it will produce a complex that is C5H5N+SO2.O-. This is step 2, and then step 3. In step 3, C5H5N+SO2O- plus it will react with methanol and it will form a stable complex CH3OH, CH3O, SO2O-. This one is the stable complex. This is the stable complex. Here pyridine is added to create the basic environment, as well as due to presence of pyridine, the stable complex will form and that will act as a buffer solution. So condition of our Karl Fischer equimetry or Karl Fischer titration will be stable. But basic thing is iodine. Due to presence of iodine, there will be determination of moisture content in the Karl Fischer titration. So this is the overview about the Karl Fischer titration or Karl Fischer equimetry. So in step 1, water content which is present here in the sample will react with iodine and SO2, and it will form SO3 and HI. So main basic thing is HI. Here due to presence of HI, it will give H plus ion and I minus ion, and due to I minus ion, current flow will start. Okay, so at the end point, H2O will be finished, means amount of H2O will be zero in the sample at the end point, because all H2O will react with the I2. In that condition, there will be no further increment in the I minus ion. So current flow at the end point will be stagnant. That current flow will not increase further, that will stagnant, that will be constant, there will be no increment in the current flow, that will be the end point. In next step, SO3, this SO3 will react with pyridine and it will form this complex, and this complex will again react with methanol and it will form a stable complex. So here pyridine is added for to create the basic environment as well as to create the buffer condition in the Karl Fischer equimetry. So this is the overview about the Karl Fischer titration. Here one more thing we have to take care, that all reagent should be moisture free, means methanol should be moisture free, means moisture content of methanol should not be more than 0.03%, and we will use anhydrous pyridine, as well as all thing will be anhydrous. We will avoid the moisture content in any step of the titration. Thank you.